Good day, everyone. My name is Shane. I'm with the Crypto Blend, and today we're going to be talking about Ravencoin. Okay, we're going to take a look at the market cap, look at the token supply. We're going to look at what it is, what purpose it serves, a key partnership that I found interesting, along with the roadmap and a few closing thoughts. So first off, today we're down 14%. Sitting at a market cap of $27.3 million with 276,000 24-hour volume, with a max supply of 21 billion and only 774 million in circulating supply. Okay, that was a big concern of mine, being that that is nothing in comparison to the total supply. And when there is a big supply and the tokens get distributed, the value of the token goes down. Okay, but we'll dive into that. Okay, some of the only two exchanges that you can find Ravencoin on are Crypto Bridge, sitting at 271,000 in 24-hour volume. Crypto Bridge is just a decentralized exchange, and then Nanox is a nano based exchange with only an insignificant amount of volume, 24-hour volume, so 5,000, right? So now what we're going to do is, one thing that I wanted to point out is on their website, I was going to pull it up and go through it, but this article alone will tell you everything you need to know, the partnership, what the coin is, and the new hashing algorithm. So those are the key points I wanted to go over. And besides that fact is that there is no about team. There is no team that I could find either on their GitHub or even on their main page. And to me, I like to see that when I'm doing my fundamental analysis. I want to know the experience of the different team members, and I wasn't able to find that. So that instantly for me was a negative tick on the board, if you know what I mean. So not too impressed by that. Maybe there's a reason and maybe you can point it out. But we'll keep going into the project and what it is, and start to cover this. If you haven't already, make sure you like and subscribe. Also, I have linked in the bottom a Discord channel that I run. It's fundamental analysis, technical analysis, news, and daily chat. Okay, so let's get into the partnership that I found with the Overstock CEO, Patrick Byrne. Mentions that he put millions of dollars into the Ravencoin. So to me, that obviously shows that he has trust in this coin, although it's only, what, 3-4 months old. Ravencoin launched on January 3rd. So, you know, there's definitely something to be said about someone like Patrick Byrne investing millions of dollars into this coin. So it also goes on to say that in the Ravencoin's opening line on their blog post of November 1st, opens with a line from Game of Thrones: "In the fictional world of Westeros, ravens are used as messengers who carry statements of truth." Probably in that tone of voice. Ravencoin is a use case specific blockchain designed to carry statements of truth about who owns what assets. Okay. So the mission behind Ravencoin is to create a system where anyone can create an asset for anything. And we'll cover what types of assets are listed as far as just some examples. Obviously, there are going to be a lot more examples or use cases if they can bring this project to life. Because right now it is just an idea. But we'll cover that a little bit more. Okay, if we look at the new hashing algorithm, Byron has offered some pretty high praise of Ravencoin in his interview, comparing it to Bitcoin. And I'll pause right there. Ravencoin is a fork of the Bitcoin code. So Ravencoin wants to basically do what Bitcoin was meant to do, only in a more cost-effective, energy-efficient way as it continues. 1,000 times more energy efficient. He goes on to outline the problem with mining price increase and the centralization around ASIC production and cheap electricity. So they have a new algorithm right here. It's X16R. Let me move myself over here for you guys so you can see that better. But the X16R is a new hashing algorithm that the Ravencoin has come out with. It is the most recent up to date. It kind of goes into that here. Okay. For examples, the SHA-256 was for Bitcoin, Script for Litecoin, Ethash for Ethereum, X11 for Dash, X13, 15, 17, and now X16R for better mining algorithms. And what it essentially is the X16R algorithm intends to solve this problem by constantly disrupting the orders of the hashing algorithms. The white paper explains the hashing algorithms are the same proven algorithms using X15 and SHA-512, but the ordering is changed based on the hash of the previous block. So that's a neat, another key function of the Ravencoin is the ASIC resistance. ASIC mining has become kind of the talk. It is because it's becoming so large that ASIC mining is gaining majority ownership over currencies like Bitcoin and Ethereum. So it's kind of a concern for a lot of people right now. The quote here says, this recording does not make an ASIC impossible to build, but it does require that the ASIC adapts to additional input, which is more easily accomplished by a CPU or GPU. Okay, so in a nutshell, Ravencoin's primary task is to implement a blockchain which is optimized specifically for the use case of transferring assets, such as tokens, from one holder to another. So, yeah, that's the mission. That's what they're looking to accomplish. Okay, so it goes on, talks about some other people's thoughts, but you can kind of come up with your own thoughts so far. Okay, if we look at the roadmap here, what has already been completed. This gives you an idea of how the mining works. It's 1,000 times the coin distribution. There's 21 billion in total, 10 times faster than blocks. So essentially 1,000 coins per minute because, you know, one block per minute is mined. So that also tailors to the fact that there are a small amount of coins in circulation, but being that there's 1,000 coins per minute being mined, you know, that's kind of weighs it out just a little bit. In-app CPU mining, difficulty adjustment, all that. Okay, ASIC resistance, a published commitment to continual attempts at ASIC resistance. If ASICs are created for X16R, then we will, at a specific block number, modify one of the algorithms to add Equihash, Ethash, or similar efforts to increase the resistance to ASIC miners for Raven. Okay, and then support. The way they want to lay out their token distribution for assets, so when someone creates an asset, they have to give it a name, they have to give it a unique character. And then there's some specific qualifications, and it gives some examples here. So the Raven used it to issue assets will be sent to a burn address, which will reduce the amount of Raven available. Okay, so that's another fact when we look at the total supply and the circulating supply. When an asset is created, the Raven is sent to a burn address, which will then make the total supply even larger. But until it hits that 21 billion, what that does is, with that such a big gap, it dilutes the price as they as the coins are mined, they're brought to the ecosystem, stuff like that. Okay, so that's, I mean, there's more on the roadmap, but there's nothing specific. It's kind of, like I said, at this point, it is an idea. It is, there's nothing in place. So just kind of bringing all these ideas to fruition is what is going to make this coin worth anything. Kind of a concern of mine. Okay. If we go back a little bit, I was talking about how assets can be used. as per the Raven token. Assets are tokens, or tokens can be used for anything the creators imagine can conjure. The ideas presented here are just a sampling. So gold bars, physical assets, you know, silver, land deeds, DC comics, energy credits. Okay, then you got shares of a company or a stock represented by a token rather than a physical stock certificate. Okay, you can also do limited partnerships, represent a co-op, royalty sharing or profit sharing platform. You've got virtual goods, tickets to a Baltimore game, you know, game items. So like if you wanted to get a sword in a game or something like that, you could use the Ravencoin, or even gift cards, airline miles, and reward points. Like I said, I'm sure there's a ton of different use cases, but those are just a few to name. Okay, something else I wanted to point out to just give a deeper understanding, kind of an example. So a young child in a country that is permitted could create a token that represents a lemonade stand business. Suppose she creates 10,000 lemonade tokens. Those tokens could be used to raise funds for the lemonade stand at 1 penny per lemonade. So the lemonade is the unique name. It's the entity. Okay, the token allowing her to raise $100 to build her business. Those tokens can be sold and transferred easily by the owners. Suppose the lemonade stand does extraordinarily well because the neighborhood is invested in this entrepreneurial project. Now our fictional 8-year-old wants to reward those who believed in her project. With one command, she can send profits denominated in any value RVN may have to lemonade token holders. There can even be new holders of lemonade tokens that she's never even met. The built-in ease of use should allow anyone anywhere in the world to do so on a mobile phone or computer running Windows, Mac, or Linux. Okay, so that's just kind of an example of how a use case would be using a token. Okay, so other than that, guys, I'm going to close it up. That's as much as I have dug into this project. I read the white paper. I did the roadmap. You know, I looked all over the website. Sorry, but overall, I'm not 100% impressed. I'm not going to invest at this point. This is not something that I'm like gung ho about. It is intriguing to me. I've heard it's like the next Bitcoin. You know, there's obviously the CEO of Overstock sees something in this token. So, you know, there's potential here. I'm not saying it's a bad coin by any means, but as per my fundamental analysis, there isn't enough information here for me to jump right in with both feet. You know what I'm saying? So, as they roll out more information and I can, you know, keep up to date, I may invest in the future. But as of right now, I'm not going to, but, overall I would probably give this coin a 3 out of 5 stars. And to wrap this up, guys, thank you for watching. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, and, if you're not part of our Discord channel, join that below. It's in the comments. You can join. It's totally free. We do news, technical analysis, fundamental analysis, along with just a community chat where other investors and enthusiasts congregate. Okay. So thank you for watching. We will see you on the next video. Peace.